windy today, but there's a couple trees I hate out here on the riverbank, so go ahead and get those down while I'm out here. Alright, see that tree right there? See how much it's at an angle? I should have cut it down about 2 or 3 years ago. Normally the water is about 10 feet lower and you can walk out to that tree. But that tree used to be upright and it used to be right around in here beneath this tree. So it fell over and slid down the bank like that. You can see these trees right here. Look how much they're leaning. Only a matter of time before this big tree and that root ball right there leans over and slides down the bank just like that one. And if you don't believe me, you can look across the river there. There's a huge area that all slid into the river there. And that's just what happens. These big heavy trees, saturated soil, and it slips right off. This one's here, pretty good size. Obviously dead all the way up, but sounded fairly solid down here. So we'll see on this one. You can see the cuts on these are a little bit different. I build the wedge on the front here, so that's a cut perpendicular to the tree. Not perpendicular flat, but you know, perpendicular to the tree run here. So that's what that one is. And then I cut like that to get a wedge and knock that out. Then after that, I bore right through about the center, just an inch or maybe 2 inches higher than my wedge. Bore all the way through from one side to the other. Then once that's done, I start my back cut. And when I cut this back, it goes over and this ledge right here keeps that leaner from kicking back. So all these tensile you know, parts of the tree, all that outside edge of the tree is really tight and tensile with all that weight leaning over, pulling that side tight. So if you don't do that, sometimes you'll get cut in here and it'll start to tip over right here and then it goes over, but then it doesn't rip through all this shit here, or it'll peel up the middle of the tree and this in the back will kick out that way. So this little plunge cut really helps you follow them a little bit better when they're leaning. Yeah. That one probably ought to go, but it's not on the top of my list right now. It'll go soon. That one needs to go, but it's too muddy around it. I don't want to get it down there right now. Off-roading in the golf cart. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah, look what we just went through. Two-wheel drive, baby. This is one I hate the most. And it's hard to get to no matter what. But man, look how much that tree sucks. Let's see if we can find a way down there halfway and get it cut down. Thank you. might be a little problem. It's probably gonna get hung up in that big tree. I'm just doing a little one there. Yeah. I think that's enough falling for today. Basically all these over here and anyone I can get to easily with the mini, I just bring up into this flat area here. Give me a spot to limb them and log them, and then I load the logs in a trailer. Take them to the neighbor who's got a wood burning stove for the winter. There's the view of the Green River. Did you hear that fish jump? Sounded like a big one. A lot of work to keep it pretty down here, but I think it's worth it. Well, we did pretty good last night. That pile pretty much all burned down. There's a big stump in there and another log or two. Probably jump on the skid steer. I was just coming down to check things out. Gonna get on the skid steer and load out this pile, that pile, and toss them in the fire. And then these logs, put on the trailer, take to the neighbor's house. And then come down here and probably do same thing. I'll probably just haul these over to that pile that's already burning. That's mostly that stump we took out. And then up there's a big pile of brush too. And some more logs to go to the neighbor. All right, well, I think that's gonna about wrap this video up. I got a lot of work done. Got a third load of logs to go over to the neighbor's house. I've got the fire back there burning for the third night in a row. And a lot of trees cleared here. I didn't count exactly how many it was, but maybe when I do the video footage, I can count them. I may not have got all of them either, but river looks really nice so far. Got a lot of leaners over, and we're gonna go ahead and deliver these to the neighbors now and give them a little Easter basket present and call it a night. Appreciate you guys watching. If you enjoy these videos, give me a like, subscribe. I appreciate it. Thank you.